Hello and welcome to this channel. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. In this video, we are discussing about Java Server Pages syntax. So we will understand the basic use of simple syntax, that is elements involved with the JSP development. So elements of JSP. So the elements of JSP are first scriptlet. So a scriptlet can contain any number of Java language statements, variable or method declarations or expressions that are valid in the page scripting language. So the syntax of scriptlet is code fragment, and you can write the XML equivalent of the syntax like a JSP scriptlet code fragment and JSP scriptlet. So any text, HTML tags or JSP elements you write must be outside the scriptlet. So we have HTML head, title, then hello world, title, head, body, hello world, out.print and done, then body HTML. So assuming that Apache Tomcat is installed in C Apache Tomcat and your environment is set up as per the environment setup, then JSP declaration. So JSP declaration declares one or more variables or methods that you can use in Java code later in the JSP file. And you must declare the variable or method before you use it in the JSP file. So syntax for JSP declaration, JSP declaration, code fragment, JSP declaration. Then JSP expression. JSP expression element contains a scripting language expression that is evaluated, converted to a string and inserted where the expression appears in the JSP file. So because the value of an expression is converted to a string, you can use an expression with a line of text whether or not it is tagged with HTML in a JSP file. And the expression element can contain any expression that is valid according to Java language specification. But you cannot use a semicolon to end an expression. JSP comments mass text or statements that the JSP container should ignore. And JSP comment is useful when you want to hide or comment out part of your JSP page. So there are a small number of special constructs you can use in various cases to insert comments or characters. And then comment, a JSP comment ignored by JSP engine, then an HTML comment ignored by browser, then JSP directive. JSP directive affects the overall structure of the servlet class, and it usually has the form @directive equal to attribute value. So there are three types of directive tag. @page defines page dependent attributes such as scripting language, error page and buffering requirements. @include includes a file during the translation phase. @taglib declares a tag library containing custom actions used in JSP page. Then JSP actions use constructs in XML syntax to control the behavior of the servlet engine. And you can dynamically insert a file, reuse Java Beans components, forward the user to another page, or generate HTML for Java plugin. And there is only one syntax for the action element, as it conforms to XML standard. JSP action name, attribute value, and action elements are basically predefined functions. JSP include includes a file at the time the page is requested. JSP use bean finds or instantiates a Java bean. JSP set property sets the property of a Java bean. JSP get property inserts the property of a Java bean into the output. JSP forward forwards the requester to a new page. JSP plugin generates browser specific code that makes an object or embed tag for the Java plugin. JSP element defines XML elements dynamically. JSP attribute defines dynamically defined XML elements attribute. JSP body defines dynamically defined XML elements body. And JSP text used to write template text in JSP pages and documents. So this was a brief discussion on Java Server Pages. And we will be discussing more on Java in the upcoming videos. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. Thank you for watching this video. Bye for now.